I guess I'm live. If you guys can see me, hear me, I comment something. Okay, so welcome to the first Being You with Being Saru. Yes, you guys have started watching. Hi Surya, hi Crazy Vinod, Leo, Baby Hall, hi Zaba. Okay, so hi guys, welcome to my first live chat show, and it's called Being You with Being Saru. So in any case, we are going to have a guest on our live show and we're going to talk a lot of interesting things with them. But before that, எப்பவுமே நம்ம சொல்லுவோம் இல்ல, இஃப் டிராவலிங் வாஸ் ஃப்ரீ யூ வில் நெவர் சி மீ அகேன் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு, லைக் ஒரு பேக் எடுத்துட்டு அப்படியே எங்கேயாச்சும் போயிடலாம் அண்ட் அதுக்கப்புறம் திரும்பியே வரக்கூடாது, இந்த ஆஃபீஸ் வேணாம், இந்த வேலை வேணாம், இந்த சேலரி வேணாம், இந்த பேஜெக் வேணாம், திவாலிக்கு போனஸ் வேணாம், இந்த மாதிரி நிறைய விஷயங்கள் வி ஆல்வேஸ் சே, ரைட்? ஸோ அதெல்லாம் சொல்றதுக்கு நல்லா தான் இருக்கு, பட் இன் ரியாலிட்டி இட்ஸ் நாட் தட் ஈஸி. ஒரு லாங் வீக்கெண்டுக்கு ஒரு வெக்கேஷன் பிளான் பண்றதே இஸ் வெரி வெரி டிஃபிகல்ட் ஃபார் அஸ் அண்ட் ஃபார் அஸ் யூனோ ஃபார் கேர்ள்ஸ். எப்பவுமே வேணுமோ வி வாண்டட் டு டிராவல் வீட்டில் சொல்லுவாங்க. யூ மஸ்ட் ஹவ் சீன் இன் மை ரீசென்ட் பீங்ஸ் ஆர் வீடியோஸ். கல்யாணம் பண்ணிட்டு போ, நீ தனியாக போனால் சேஃப்டி இல்லை, யூ கான் டிராவல், அண்ட் தென் ஆஃப்டர் மேரேஜ் கல்யாணம் பண்ணிட்டு ஊர் சுற்றுவீங்களா, யூ ஷுட் பி ரெஸ்பான்சிபிள், சேவ் ஃபியூச்சர், பிளா 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 பிளா, ரைட்? பட் இமேஜின் ஆஃப்டர் மேரேஜ் யூ அண்ட் யுவர் ஹஸ்பண்ட் டிசைட் டு லைக் லெட்ஸ் கோ டிராவல் த வேர்ல்ட், சீ த வேர்ல்ட்னா, வை ஆர் வி சிட்டிங் ஹியர்? அண்ட் தென் இஃப் த ட்ரீம் ரியலி கம்ஸ் ட்ரூ, ஹவ் வில் இட் பி, ரைட்? But for someone, it actually came true, and we are going to have one such couple today on my show. We're going to have Ruchi and Avi joining us soon from Second Breakfast. So before that, I just want you all to, you know, join the live and be ready to welcome them on our family space. Hi, hi everybody. Hi Munisha. Hi Jasper Z. Hi Kurvi Kumar. DQ Salman. I wish that was Dulkar Salman, but I'm happy DQ Salman you joined me also. So in some time Ruchi and Avi will join us from Second Breakfast, and we're gonna ask them a lot of questions. Let me see if I can add them. So while we are waiting for Ruchi and Avi to start, it's going to be a live chat show. Hi guys! Hi. So guys, meet Ruchi and Avi. They are from Second Breakfast and they are our guests today. Guys, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So Ruchi and Avi are right now in Japan. They're going to celebrate Diwali in Japan. So how excited are you for Diwali in Japan?
We're so excited. Like, there's some cultural celebration going on here as well today. So everyone's dressed up in their traditional clothes right now and roaming the streets, playing drums and all that. So it's really nice. And otherwise also, it's like a very beautiful city to explore. So we're really excited.
Nice. So my dear Tamil Makkals, apologies here because we're going to talk in English, because Ruchi and Avi can communicate with us only in English, and we did try Tamil, but it will take some time for them to learn it. So we'll give them that time. But for now, please bear our English. And if you want subtitles later, I will take the pain and do it for you. But for now, please bear our English. Even if there are grammar mistakes, especially with me, forgive me. And so Ruchi and Avi, before me telling about what you guys are doing, you tell us about what you guys are doing. You guys are traveling the world, like, Avi, you know, you're every girl's dream husband, because after marriage you're saying, come, let's go travel the world. How did this happen, guys?
You want to take that?
So when we met, we always really wanted to travel. We were like, this 1 week, 2 week vacation won't do it for us. We just want to spend like at least months in the same place and explore as much as possible. So somehow we made that happen. Just gave up our apartment in Bangalore. We sold everything that we had. We didn't have much, but we sold everything that we had. We saved almost everything that we earned, we saved for 2 years, and then we just took off. So since November 2016 we are traveling. So we spend about 2-3 months in each country, and this November 16th will be 2 years.
17.
So basically, after your marriage, your honeymoon never ended. You guys are on and on about it.
Yeah, it's like a never-ending honeymoon.
Yeah, someone wrote about us, and actually that was the title
of
the...
Yeah, so in a Kannada newspaper, they said it's a never-ending honeymoon. But for our actual honeymoon, we didn't do anything. So.
Yes, guys, you don't have to, you know, be worried about going to a honeymoon and all. You guys are on travel all the time. So tell me, it's very difficult, you know, for us to plan a single weekend and go somewhere, the cost, the expenses, the flight and bills. How do you guys manage? Do you guys pay bills? Do you have something called bills? Is there anything like that going on with y'all?
So we don't have traditional bills like electricity bill and water bill or Wi-Fi bill and things like that. But we have like our major bills are flight tickets and visa.
Yeah.
Okay.
Our most of our expenses are flight tickets and visa. And of course, accommodation wherever we are going. So
if you're staying for long term in a particular city, like if you're staying 1 or 2 months, then we book apartments or we book like Airbnb for a month. But if you're staying for a short time, we like hotels because they keep it clean.
Okay. So we all have this doubt, and does traveling really, you know, give you that much money where you can keep going on and on about it? Like being a travel blogger, are you really making so much money? Like I'm really considering doing something like that, and so many people watching, they're like, okay, I can also quit my job and go see the world. It seems easy. Is it really easy?
So travel blogging, I would say, is fairly easy. So if you're passionate about traveling, you can just start a blog. No, you don't need any investment to start a blog. Just open up a blogging like blogger.com or WordPress, get a free site and start blogging about things you're passionate about, whatever it is, food, travel, lifestyle, fashion, anything. But making money from it is a whole different ballgame. Like you have to have audience to make money for it. Why would someone pay to read your blog? Because you have an audience, right? So you're inspiring people to do something, or you're providing some information to them or something like that. So from blogging itself, we don't make that much money. We just do occasionally do the sponsored posts or a sponsored trip with tourism boards and all. Most of our income actually comes from behind the scenes. It's from our freelance projects. Avi works as a software consultant and I do social media writing and other projects.
Okay, so you guys are actually having a job and then you're doing it while you're traveling.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a location independent job. Like we are also working Monday to Friday, but it's just that we are not working in a single place. We are just like, we change places from one time to the other. On the weekend, we just explore. So we are in a different place every other weekend. That helps. But otherwise, we are also sitting and working Monday to Friday.
So
you were about to say something.
So what's different is that sometimes if you feel like early morning you want to take a walk in some place, go see a waterfall or a park or a temple or something like that in a new place, we get to do that. But then we come back and we sit and work at a cafe, and then in the evening again we can explore and all that. So the best thing is that we are getting a local way of living, like how locals also just, they come to cafes, they work, they usually in the evenings everyone's like hanging out and stuff. So that experience you don't get when you are just coming for 1 or 2 weeks holiday.
Okay.
Actually, in the last 2 years, our real holiday was just the first time. In the last 1 week, we have taken a holiday where we didn't actually work. So like that's the first holiday in the last 2 years since we started traveling. Otherwise, we have been constantly working.
Yeah, so for Japan we decided we really don't want to like try to work and all that. We just want to really explore the place and wake up at whatever time we want, go to spas, just see the place. So last week was our vacation, annual vacation, where we saw the northern countryside of Japan called Hokkaido.
Okay.
And it's like a winter wonderland. It's just straight out of a Japanese fairy tale. Oh my god.
Cool. So those of you who just joined us, Ruchi and Avi are travel bloggers. They are from Second Breakfast and they are here with us today for a live chat interview. In the end of the session, we are going to have a question and answer session. So the last 5 minutes, we are dedicating to all your questions. So keep your questions until then and stay in live with us. So, Ruchi and Avi, I have a question. Since you guys, like, you don't have a house, you've sold everything you had and you guys are on the travel. Basically, you know, when you start doing this, the whole insecurity of what will I do when I settle down? I need a house, when I have, like, a family, we need to have certain security and everything. So, does that insecurity hit you guys or do you have backup plans? What is in the game for you?
So, backup plans, I think, if you have little bit of money saved up, I don't think you need a plan as such. You just need time. And that's like the real currency is time that most people don't realize is that what matters in the end is if you have time to do something or time to figure it out. So we have enough money so that we can take some time off, figure it out if we want to settle down or anything. But there's like so many countries still to visit. So I don't think we need a backup plan anytime soon.
Oh God, you guys are living everybody's dream life and everybody's fantasy life. So, you know, whenever we travel, we feel like maybe I should stay in this place for 2 more days, but then I have a flight to go, I have like an office to go to, so I can't stay back. But you guys don't have anything like that. You guys like Vietnam and you guys decided to stay there for like 6 months, extend 5 more months. So tell us about that.
So, Vietnam visa, you get 3 months. But when we went to Vietnam, we were like, okay, let's just stay 1 month and see what it's like and all that. And 1 month, we were like completely in love with Vietnam. We were like, that country is amazing. The people are so wonderful. You'll just walk down a street. At the end of the day, you'll have 2 friends. Minimum.
Okay. Yeah.
That's nice.
And the people are so welcoming. The food is amazing. And we really liked it. So, we stayed. 1 month became 3 months, and then to extend our visa, we had to come back to India. And then you don't have to come back to India to extend it. We just came back for my friend's wedding, and then you have to exit the country and come back in. So we just did that, and we went back to Vietnam. We had a choice of going anywhere else, but we chose to go back to Vietnam again and spend another 3 months.
That's nice. So basically, you know, telling my mom that I want to travel, it's like my biggest nightmare. I have to think about 10 reasons, 20 reasons, and 10 of my friends should come and tell her, listen, this is where she's going, we are there, she is safe and all that. You guys decided to sell everything you have and go on a never-ending trip. How cool were your parents about it? Were they really cool about it, or how did you convince them?
So let me check if my mom is on the live. I don't think so. Okay, so yeah, before we were married, when we were traveling, we just used to lie. I would tell my at home that I'm traveling with my friend, and then
okay.
I guess they know, but they didn't question it that much. Even his parents didn't. They thought he was going alone. But before we were married, like my parents, when I would tell them that we are going to just not have a house and not live anywhere or have a base or anything, we'll travel. They wouldn't really believe it, you know. And even when we started traveling, they were like, 6 months they'll travel, then they'll come back. They're just, now they have no responsibilities. After some time, they'll come back. But 6 months became a year. Then we came back to India. We spent 2-3 months in India with both of our parents. My family is in Bombay and his family is in Mysore. And then we were like, again, we were applying for visas, booking tickets, packing. So they're like, now they're used to it. That we'll be doing it for at least another few years.
So they finally accepted the fact that you guys are not going to settle down in one house or, you know, one city for something.
We don't know if they have accepted it or not, but they're okay with whatever we are doing right now. So that makes us happy. We don't have to do anything.
Occasionally, my parents will be like, oh, this flat is available for 45 lakhs. Why don't you guys put down some money? But if we do that, we won't have any money to travel.
Okay, so that gives us a takeaway. Like, your parents are, however, you know, open-minded they are, they're not really going to accept your craziness. So you just be crazy. I think that will be our takeaway from this interview.
Yeah.
But tell me about your profession, Gajruchi. You're a lawyer. And then you changed into, you know, digital marketing, and now you're a blogger. How did this whole transformation happen? Because becoming a lawyer is not easy. You put a lot of time and number of years in as investment in your education. And then finally, you know, changing profession. How did you go through that process? How was that decision-making thing happening for you?
So when I graduated from school, I had chosen science in school, but I knew that I don't want any like engineering or medicine or anything of that sort, because I knew that I would struggle and I would not be good at it at all. So okay. I chose law because I had a vague idea and was interested in some of the subjects. And when I started studying law, I enjoyed studying the law subjects. But then when I graduated, I worked as a lawyer for 3 years. And after that, I felt like there's more that I want to do creatively. I didn't enjoy the work as much. And I knew that if I be in the lawyer profession, I'll get to a certain level, but I'll not... Neither will I achieve like the high-paying suits-type salaries, nor will I get something that makes me truly happy. So I just wanted to search for something that my skills and my passion could, where both my skill and passion would like be the perfect mix.
I think a lot of us are struggling to find that perfect mix point, and I'm super happy for you that you found it. And Abhi, tell us about your profession. How are you managing? Are you doing something in tech, and then you're traveling and you're managing the travel? How is it all happening for you?
So I've been professionally working for 8-9 years now. So since the beginning, I was into startups, in the startup world and everything. So in the startup world, this location independent working was a big thing. Like, we were one of the first startups where I used to work. We were the first location independent team where we didn't even have an office. So we could work from anywhere. For the first 6 months, we worked from Bangalore, and then we got a chance to go to South America for 6 months. That's the first time I ever like stepped out of the country. And since then, I think I've been in India for like 1.5 years. That's it. For the last like 7 to 8 years, I've been going around the world and working from wherever. So when I met her in Bangalore, that was like the year which I spent in India. And then we just met over the conversation of travel itself. And we just started from there, and we decided, okay, later we should continue traveling and not be in one place. So I was already used to traveling like this and working like this. It's just that she had to make a transition from being a lawyer, because being a lawyer, you can't do the location independent. It's not a career where you can be location independent. So it took her some time to do the transition, and then we just started traveling.
Cool. So guys, to sum up their story, they just met and they were a perfect match. They wanted to travel, so they sold everything they had. They had a simple wedding, and now they are traveling and they seem like they are not coming back. So, Ruchi and Avi, tell me something. We all have this, you know, little passion that we want to go behind and do something like what you guys are doing. To look at it from the side, to look at your Instagram profile, it looks all sweet and nice, but what is the difficulty that you guys are facing in your lifestyle?
So I think one of the most difficult thing that we face is you don't have a routine. Like, people keep saying that, okay, routines are rubbish and I want adventure. But routine is so important for the human body to function well. Like, sometimes the time zone will change, or sometimes you won't get the food that you like, or you'll not be used to the weather. So those things are things that get in the way. So like, exercise is something we can't find to do every day. So we just, sometimes we actually just walk at least like 5-6 kilometers, because we don't have time to regularly exercise unless we're staying in a place for more than 2-3 months.
But that's what we are trying to change now. Yeah. After like 2 years of traveling, we want to put in a routine somehow around traveling itself. So we have consciously started putting effort into forming a routine independent of travel. The travel will happen, but we should have a routine.
Yeah.
So we are not successful yet. It's just a beginning. So let's see where it goes.
And just finding the balance between, okay, like, I want to take time off to explore the streets, or I have to sit in and complete my work before I get to do that. So that's a balance which is, you have to get that somewhere. Either you work all night and spend the day doing things and get your sleep all ruined, or you make time for that to happen somehow.
Cool. So one last question. You know, how do you, is there like any cheat sheet to find a balance between what things you want to do and what things you're expected to do. Like, you guys have a job and you guys are doing what you're passionate about. A lot of us are finding it difficult to understand whether we are doing the right thing. Is this my space, or where should I go? Should I also start an Instagram profile? Should I become a photographer? Maybe I should become a hero. You know, a lot of us are facing those questions of what am I and how do I get to the point where I really am a good person or an expert. So how did you guys find the balance between this? Is there a cheat sheet that we can like copy paste to our lives, or is there no rule at all?
I don't think there is any rule as such. Just focus on what makes you happy and everyone else will fall into place. Everything else will fall into place. It's just figuring out the right balance for yourself. It doesn't have to make sense to anyone else. Even your parents will get convinced, and even the people who will not be convinced, don't just get rid of them. They're not your inner circle. You don't need that kind of name.
Thank you for that. And thank you, Abhi and Ruchi, for joining us today on this live. This is my first live. This is the first episode of Being You with Being Saru. And I am so glad I had you guys on the show.
We are glad we were the first guests. We are very glad.
Do you guys have anything else to say to my followers and your followers who are watching us right now?
So I just want to say, like, if you really want to do something, whether it's travel or whether it's a passion project that you have, you're a photographer or a dancer or an artist or something, and if you feel like you have a day job and you're not following your passion, just make time for it. Get up 4 hours earlier, or just do it in your lunch break. Just find time to do the things you love. Sleep a little less. Nobody at 60 will tell you that, oh, I had a lot of sleep in my youth. Nobody regrets not having enough sleep. So I think somehow make it possible to follow your passions. You'll not get time for it someday. That's a very mythical thing. Somehow make it happen.
So there's something which I follow all the time, like that you have a dream, you have something you want to achieve. Usually it will be a grand big dream. So the first thing you should do is try to break it down into smaller problems. Say if you want to become an actor or an actress or whatever, then like you need to know how to get there. If you don't know how to get there, you don't know a path, or you can't figure out a path, you will never get there. So first you break down your big dream into smaller problems. So those smaller problems will be easier to tackle, and once you start tackling one by one, it becomes a better, you can see the progress of you getting there, rather than this being this big thing which, oh, I can't achieve it, I can't do it. So that always helps me to finish a project whenever I take something up.
Thank you guys. I'm sure you guys inspire a lot of them to go travel and do what they're passionate about every day. And I'm sure some of us took a lot of takeaway from today's interview. Thank you so much for joining. Let's see if we have any questions. Pumble B is saying, so good to see you guys. And Go Vardhan is saying, Ruchi, the pictures, photographs are amazing.
And somebody's saying she's the reason behind my Bali visit. Oh, that's so nice. We love Bali. But now I hope I can get you to visit Japan. It's like it's like a dream.
So one travel destination for
everyone.
So one travel destination, even if you don't go anywhere in the world, that's all right. But make a trip to Japan.
Yeah, just sell your car. Don't get insurance.
Like, it's okay. Just save up for 10 years or something. Even if you don't want to travel, you're not a traveler. That's all right. But make a trip to Japan.
Yeah, totally worth it.
Just like Seven is asking, can you guys chat a little more? We wish, but both of us are running out of time. So we will try and catch up another day, just like Seven. And Nazreet, Tamil la varle, because we are not comfortable right now in Tamil. We will soon do a Tamil live, don't worry.
Soon I learn Tamil. When we travel in India and we come to Tamil Nadu, I will learn some Tamil. Till that, yes, we can do konjam theriyum.
And Artisha saying, Avi, good tip.
What?
She said good tips.
Good tips. Good tip. Oh, thank you.
Prejo 15 is asking, how do you guys afford to keep up the travel?
So, like anyone else, we work full time. So, it's just that we have freelance projects. All we need is Wi-Fi and our computers to just sit and work. So, we earn what a regular couple would earn in Bangalore or Delhi. And then we save most of our money for travel because we don't have expenses like paying rent for a huge apartment or buying a car or things like that.
The only extra expenses which we have is the flight tickets yeah. and the visa charges. That's the only extra expenses. Yeah, that's an expense more than someone who is living in Bangalore or Chennai. But you get a lot for spending that.
Yeah.
So you get to go to different places and live there.
Okay. So Sarvi 777 is asking, do you visit European countries also?
So Europe is a bit far away because you need a little more money than Asia. And the visa process is not easy. Like, you can't spend months together in Europe. You'll get like 14-day visa or like 25-day
visa.
Yeah,
you have to pre-plan your complete trip and you have to tell them, you have to book everything and then go. So we are not ready for that kind of travel yet because we want to land in a place and then figure it out. So that's what we like. We don't like pre-planned trips. So Europe is on the way, but I don't know when.
Maybe. Maybe towards the end of next
year. Yeah.
Okay. Nisha Varghese 88 is saying, I am definitely doing Japan retreat.
Yay.
Yay.
And RC is saying, I will definitely travel places that both of you have visited. And Surya Nish is saying, sure, next time it will be to Japan.
Hopefully we are also here.
Yeah.
Just like Seven, guys, amazing. This is like a dream to be like guys like you. Okay.
Thank you.
Keep posting and inspiring us.
That's our job. Okay. We'll do that.
You guys are doing a lot of good job for Japan tourism. So many people want to travel to Japan right now.
Yeah, they should pay us.
Yeah.
The Alchemist story is asking, what gave you the courage to do the things you do? You guys are like outlaws of Indian society.
So I always say that like it takes more courage to not do this, to just spend your life just having the dream but not doing it. You'll regret it for sure in one way or the other. So it'll take just a little bit of bravery to just follow what you want. Just when I was quitting my job, I had no idea. I wanted that whole life of living independently, paying my own rent and all that. But to save money, I went to live with my parents. And I saved a lot of money also. But the thing is to remember is you just try to live a life without regrets. There will be some regrets, of course. It's not very practical to do that. But sometimes you have to just do the crazy things. So the idea is when society and parents, you have just conditioned that responsibilities are having a job or having kids or having family or having a house. But that's really not a responsibility. Responsibility is just taking care of yourself, your mental well-being and your physical well-being. So if you're able to do that while traveling and while like earning enough money to take care of yourself, I think it works.
Yeah.
You don't have to have a house or a car in India. Just live the no EMI life.
No EMI life, yeah.
You guys are making big statements. No car, no house.
Somebody called us outlaws, so that's our new tagline. I like it.
Yeah, no EMI life, cash and carry. These are the things which we believe in. Like we don't do credit at all. Like once you get into that, then it's a different path which we don't want to take.
But the thing is that on the internet, you see all this very glorified, like, oh, leave your job, travel the world, or, you know, follow your passion and things like that. Those things are also kind of like, they are glorified on the internet. So if your actual dream is to buy a nice house in the city and to have a baby and have more babies and do that, that is, it's your thing. Just do it without any explanation to anyone.
I mean, if you really like kids, then you should be having kids.
Yeah.
You shouldn't be traveling. Or, like, if you don't like to travel, then don't travel.
Yeah.
Like, there's no force here. You should be doing what you want to.
Yeah. So, if you like something, you should just try whatever it you can to make it happen. That's a challenge that everyone should have the courage to do what they like.
So, we're moving on to the next question. Radio Raskin is asking, how do you guys manage the language?
So, we usually just learn a few phrases from Google and then we just, like, we somehow try to talk using Google Translate. Sometimes, like yesterday, we needed to go to a pharmacy and he needed a medicine for fever. And everything is in Japanese. So, I just point at my head and I say pain and they try to understand.
Yeah, most people
are very, very helpful if you just smile and be polite.
If you just smile, they're just like, okay, until now, we have not encountered people who will not help you.
Yeah, so
like
just,
that's a very big big mental block people will have, like, okay, you go to a different country, then you're alone, and that's not true at all. You just go and just tell them, you try to explain, you fumble, then they'll smile at you and try to help you. Always, no one tries to like, oh, I don't like you, don't know our language, bye-bye. No one says that. Everyone will try to help you.
Yeah, so you just smile and say hello and thank you in their language. They're very happy to help.
Okay. So guys, we are running out of time. So last few questions. What's your next destination? Polish blood is asking.
Follow us. You'll know soon.
Okay. Ben is saying, thank you so much for all the inspiration. Wish you all good health and happiness.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Wish you the same also.
Okay. And just wanted to know, how much did you spend in each country on average, if you guys are okay to disclose it?
So our expenses will be very different because sometimes we fly from a nearby country. Like, for example, if you're flying from Bali to Thailand, it's actually very cheap as compared to flying from Bangalore to Bali. So, and we spend a month or 2 months. So our expenses won't really make sense for you. But we have some Q&As on my Instagram, as well as we are planning to come up with some itineraries for you guys for a 1 week or 10-day holiday. So that'll be helpful.
But living expenses is always around like 50,000 to 60,000 rupees, which is what you would spend in the Bangalore or Chennai, wherever. So living expenses, the extra expenses are there. I'm not denying that. But the living expenses are the same as you would spend in a city in India. So at least in Southeast Asia, Europe, and of course, Japan is more expensive.
Yeah.
But Southeast Asia is not expensive at all. It's very similar to India.
So if we stay at home and like cook at home, we obviously save a lot of money.
Yeah.
But there's so much food to try. So
yeah.
Like we need to get a balance there, like between the eating outside food and I think certain countries are very, very affordable. Like, for example, I think Vietnam is a very affordable country, and so is Thailand. Bali is actually very
more
touristy
expensive
and very expensive as compared to
any other Southeast Asian
countries.
Yeah.
Okay, so I've skipped a lot of questions because the answer to that is there in the live. You can go again and watch the live and you will get the answer. And I think we are done with our questions. Thank you so much, Ruchi and Avi, for joining us.
Thank you.
Guys, you can go follow them. Sorry?
Thank you for
having
us
on your show as the first guest.
Yes, you guys are lovely. And all of you can go follow them at the second breakfast. I will share their handles in the next story. Go give them a thumbs up, send them your love and follow them and get to know what they're doing. Thank you guys. I hope to see you all soon in person sometime when you come down to Coimbatore. Do let me know, or anywhere in TN. We can say a hi in person and then we can have more beautiful discussions like this. Thank you so much for joining today. Bye guys. Happy Japan. Happy Diwali.
Happy Diwali.
Thank you. And so guys, we are going. Bye Tata. Take care.
Bye.
Bye bye. Okay, it's not ending.